tablets, and beepers. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy a gap in generations.
Again, and it is a meeting we esteem highly.
Indeed we do!
For is not your city, great Bologna, famed above others for its learning? Where is there another institution that matches yours? Can Pisa match you?
No!
Or Salerno?
No!
Or Montpellier in far off France?
No!
Or Paris?
No!
Or even the great Rockville Centre?
No!
So, proud people of a proud city, esteemed professors, we greet you once again. Many fine scenarios have we in our repertoire, and now we can see one especially in honor of your city's anniversary. Its settings here, in this very place, its manners are yours. You are its characters. So, great
Bologna!
Bologna, we come to show you yourself. The time is now, the company, the Affamati, the hungry ones.
Hungry ones? Hungry indeed, you starving
beggar. No, sir, no, you're mistaken. Oh, we are hungry, yes, but not for food. We are hungry for fame!
For fame!
Permission? What permission?
Who do you think you're talking to?
Who indeed? And who might you be, you impudent meddler?
Now, watch your tongue when you speak to a captain.
A captain? You?
Spavento de Valinferno.
Oh, did you hear? The terrible captain from Hell's Valley.
And the chief officer of this watch. This is my section of the city. I control things here. Here, you stop that.
Stop it yourself! Don't order a us around.
Pay no attention to this fella, this puffball.
You can't. Yes.
I order you by right of law, right of statute.
Oh, well, let me tell you.
Here, let me hand you. What law, statute?
By law, rogues, actors, and pickpockets are not allowed in this city.
Pickpockets? Sir, I defy you. We are no pickpockets.
No? No pickpockets? Who does not know how your actions and your pickpockets work hand in hand? I warn you, keep an eye for your valuables. While you watch the strutting players, light fingers will be at work among you. Tis a corporation as old as human cunning. So beware!
Sir, you insult us! We are the Alfamati, an ancient and honored company of
strutting players. But strutting or not, actors do not act here without a license. It is forbidden.
Forbidden? Where is it forbidden?
By law, by statute.
Statutes? Where? Show us!
Yeah, show us! Yes.
Show you?
Do you hide it? Is it in your pocket? In your trouser leg? By heaven, there's room!
Let me see! Out
of
license!
Get it!
But I haven't got it. Not here. It's in the office of the watch.
Bring it for us to see!
Oh no, a license is required.
Oh, do not be afraid. We won't run away, will we?
Oh, no!
On our honor.
On our honor.
Oh?
We promise.
All right, then. You stay here. I'll be right back.
Take your time.
Trust us. We won't budge.
And don't move.
Did you hear that, everybody? Don't move.
There. You see, we are as good as our word.
But in the meantime, we can't just stay frozen, can we? Not and keep you happy. And besides, if we know the military, we'll be through before he returns. So, while you wait, we'll continue with your entertainment, Maestro.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Alfamati Company! And now that you may better recognize us in our new scenario with our traditional costumes, we give you the Zanies. Makeup. Dr. Graziano. And the old man. We give you a sample of Cornelia's major character types: lovers, old men, and zanies and servants. Let us start with the youth. Ah, the wonder of love. Ah, love, just listen. Let it be like these two, Lelio and Isabella, as they utter lines that are eternal, speak the language of love. Here they are, the innamorati!
The innamorati!
Disperse!
Dissolve!
From my sight!
From my eyes!
I recoil!
I curse!
At the supposition that I ever loved you!
The day I first beheld you!
Though you torture me, I will never say it!
Though I perish, I shall never declare it!
You cruel fiend!
You heartless troll!
Because of you, I die!
Because of you, I die!
We die!
Come, dagger!
Come, poison!
Farewell!
The poison is too bitter.
The blade is too dull.
I love you!
Now for a zany, a servant, and which one know the best of them all? For who does not know the famous Arlecchino with the black smudges on his face from the coal mines of Bergamo? With his silliness and grace and ignorance and wit, and his sure cure for all problems, Arlecchino!
Arlecchino!
To cure my master's toothache, I will pluck an apple, slice it into four parts, place one of the pieces in his mouth, put his head into an oven well heated, and where the fruit is cooked to a turn, the toothache will be gone!
And now for one of the old men. You know him right well, for he is a citizen of your city. You may have seen him on the streets. He has a sharp eye for a business deal and a quick eye for a wench. But alas, time has taken its toll. Tofano di Scattarelli.
Tofano!
Desire and I are old friends.
My wife was a desirable woman. I remember on many occasions where I would just gaze at her. She would be in her room, in her bed, in her nightgown, and I would say to myself, now, Tufano, this is a desirable woman. What are you gonna do about it? Well, you see, desire and I are old friends. So I'd go up to her room where she lay, in her bed, in her nightgown. Desire and I are old friends. So I'd go. So I spoke to Dr. Graziano about my problem. And he said, Desire, at your age, Tufano, it's all in your head. I know it's in my head, I replied. I'd like to have it lowered a little.
And last, we give you another citizen of your city. This man is a remarkable professor of medicine from your university. Overripe with learning, this man has studied everything and understood nothing. He speaks, and his words are impressive. Here he is, Dr. Graziano.
Dr. Graziano!
Yes, I practice medicine for the sheer love of it. I nurse, I operate, I probe, I extract. I break, I slice, I smash, I dislocate, and I show no mercy whatsoever. I'm a tornado of medicine and the bane of all maladies. Known and unknown. I eradicate all fevers and chills. The 7-year itch, gallstones, noisome flesh, plague, ringworm, gout, apoplexy. Oh, and that dreaded scourge, covfefe. I wage unremitting warfare against all forms of illness. Oh, the patients may die, but I cure the disease.
And now, we give you a gap in generations.
Sounds.
Oh, my God, help me! Arlecchino, do you hear me? Quick, quick!
Oh, yes, Master, I hear you. I'm coming immediately, sooner or later. Ooh, a spider!
Oh, what a spasm! What a pain! Oh, help me!
Little spider!
Someone! Anyone help!
He's unwinding!
Antonio! Lucia, help me!
Antonio, Lucia, Master calls.
Yes, yes, what is it?
Yes, who's calling?
Run to Master, quickly. We must all help him.
Help, for God's sake.
Trot straight, Master, we are here.
We're coming, Master, as fast as we can.
You rogues, you zanies, quick, take me in.
Master, do not bend over, sir. We'll die of the cramps.
Take my arm, rest on me.
Oh, what a... twists his eyeball in knots. Oh, the devil will have me before the day is over.
Take care, Master.
Oh. Quiet, Master. Let us help you.
Oh, there's a scoundrel. I'll teach you to desert me in my dying hour. Arlecchino. Oh, you son of a coal miner!
Help me down!
Come on, you rogues. Have my son Lelio and the good Dr. Graziano been sent for?
They'll be here shortly. Now you just lie down and save your strength.
Don't they know they're imposing on me? I have to wait until they arrive before I can die.
Close, Master.
Oh, yes, Arlecchino, less than an hour.
An hour? Yeah, would you say 45 minutes?
Oh, no, I think it's more like 35.
Oh. Maybe you're right. Maybe you're not dying. Maybe it is something you ate.
I am dying. It was not something I ate. I didn't eat anything. Just something to drink.
Oh, what?
Nothing. Just some wine.
Wine, is that all?
Well, we were sitting at the inn. My old friend, Signor Tofano di Scattarelli, Dr. Graziano, and I drinking and recalling old times when we were young and the terror of the town.
Yes, we know, and the devil with the girls.
Yes, and then Rufiana, the courtesan, came by. You know, the Duke's mistress. And she was going to the Duke's. And we began to imagine all sorts of things. And then Tofano, the old fool, began to get excited, and then, well,
oh.
And, well, I got excited too. And nothing would happen except something must be done. We may be old, but we were too wise and experienced to go to a waste. Well, the upshot was that Dr. Graziano suddenly got very mysterious, swearing us to secrecy. Disclose to us his knowledge of a magical potion.
Magical!
Shh! An elixir of youth. It was at his home. We went there. He closed himself in his study while Tofano and I waited in his anteroom. Every sound that came from inside, our excitement rose to fever pitch. Finally, he emerged with the elixir.
Elixir? Try Pirelli's miracle elixir. That'll do the trick, sir. True, sir, true.
And bade us to follow him. We went through the dark streets to the cemetery where at the exact moment when three clouds in the shape of an oyster cast themselves upon the moon, he says, drink.
And
we drank. And well, right away something happened and it was, right away we went back to the inn and had some more wine and then went out on the town like two devils let loose out of hell. And then
I had to come along and pick up the pieces. This will be known as the year of the great hangover.
Hangover? Hangover? Oh. Oh, something is not right. Something is coming.
Steady, Master, steady. Help, quick, help. Steady, steady.
I have such a pain.
Be calm, Master, be calm.
Oh.
Help, quick, help.
Oh, this old rogue. Oh.
Come on.
I'm dying, damn it.
Here, Master.
Oh, no, not that.
Zany.
Oh, what a relief. I'm glad that spasm is over.
Now, Master, don't take on so. Your stomach is just a little queasy, that's all.
Yes, it's just. Queasy, did you say? Oh.
Steady,
Steady, Master, steady. Help, quick, help. Calm yourself, Master.
Oh,
calm
yes,
yourself.
I must, but it's...
Oh. Here, Master.
Oh, what? No, no!
Not that, not that! Out, you fool, out! There, Master, be steady. Be calm.
Oh, Dr. Graziano, where can you be?
Both he and your son will...
Oh, Dr. Graziano, why are you staying so long? Help me, I'm dying!
You sent for me? I'm here, Dr. Graziano. At your service.
He's just in time. How fortunate.
I got your message. I came as quick as I could. I always hurry to the side of disease and death. Though, you should know I had to leave my class at the university, where my students eagerly awaited my lecture on the theories of Hippocrates, as interpreted by Galen, given in my own inimitable style.
Doctor!
Oh, be quiet. You're disturbing me.
Quiet. You're interrupting a very fluent case of vocal diarrhea.
I was just about to dissect the heart of my discourse when your messenger interrupted my diagnosis. I was explaining to my students the adventrication of that splenetic organ. The spleen is a continuous, fixed result when concretion of the upper back.
Doctor, for God's sake!
Quiet!
Quiet! Oh.
I was saying the adventrication of the spleen is a...
Shh! Doctor, renowned sir, here is a patient wonderfully ill.
Oh, I see. Your heart is where your pulse should be, and your pulse is where your heart should be. Therefore, we must turn you around and readjust. Arlecchino?
Let's go.
Oh, my head is swelling. It's going to burst.
Ah, no desired state of the body is ever attained easily. Be patient. Think you to renew the flow of life like that? Ah, youth is a prize all men see. My medicine, the draught of which you drank last night, will restore your youth. It is a potion gleaned from a lifetime of study in the work of the ancients. Take heart, suffer.
Oh.
Thus we re-up the old, thus we achieve the new. Again I say, youth will be yours.
Oh, my God, you've killed me!
That's progress.
Oh. Ah, Dr. Graziano is here, I see. You, Arlecchino, announce me.
Next.
Announce me.
But your father...
Announce me. Dr. Graziano is here, therefore it is a formal occasion.
But your father, he is dying?
All the more reason for haste. Announce me.
What shall I say?
Give my title.
Your title? You're a nobleman?
No, fool, my university title.
But why?
Idiot. Don't you know that student officers take precedence over ordinary masters?
Me? Ordinary?
You are only of the faculty. I am a student officer.
An officer. You're an officer. Did you hear that?
Fool, I have the highest office. In the university, I am the student leader, superior to the faculty. I have many fine privileges. Of all the students, I alone need not go armed to class. And in the town, I am second only to the Duke. In all processions, I march only behind him, ahead of cardinals and mayors even. I am rector.
Did you hear? He's an erector.
What's that? You a member of some sex club?
Not. I am Rector Magnificus, the elected head of all the students in my guild. Come, announce me.
What shall I say?
Idiot, repeat after me.
Ah, Lelio di Vesignosi.
Ah, Lelio di Vesignosi.
Rector Magnificus of the Student Guild.
Rector Magnificus of the Student Guild.
Of the ancient and honored University of Bologna.
Of the ancient and honored University of Bologna. For you.
There, Father, I came as fast as I could. How are you?
Oh, well, you ask, Melmi, you ask my son. My time has come.
23 minutes.
Oh. Well, what's the matter, Father?
It's fitting you should ask. Though little understand, Rector Magnificus or not, he's presently troubled by a false effluvium. But shortly, by my sure diagnosis, a true effluvium will commence.
and
then... Oh, damn your effluviums! You've done me in!
Come, my son, hear me. My last request.
Yes, father?
Oh, my wish, my last wish. Oh, how can I say?
Oh, no, father, don't say your last.
Oh, there, there, old master. There, there, young master. Don't take on so.
Yes, just so. Time presses.
15 minutes.
Hear me. All my affairs are to be settled. My coal mines in Bergamo, my brick factory, and my shipping business in Venice that I left so long ago to go searching for my wife, your mother, and your long-lost little twin sister. All these are yours. You must assume responsibility.
Yes, father.
Become head of the family.
Yes, father.
Marry the right girl.
Well...
Leave the university.
Yes, father, as you... What's that at last?
Oh, yes, my son. Oh, leave the university right away.
What? No, that's impossible.
Oh, don't be modest. You're almost grown.
Almost grown? Almost? I am grown. I'm rector.
Magnificent.
Yes, my son. Yes,
but... No, father, no. What? Leave the university?
Of course.
Resign my position.
Now, Tabano's daughter is about...
But I've just been elected on my student rights platform.
Oh, damn your platform.
When I'm ready to begin my program.
What are you talking about?
Father, I lead the assault. 4 non-negotiable demands. That's my program. One, any professor tardy to his 6 a.m. lecture will be fined 10 florins. Two, professors who dodge difficult questions, 15 florins. Three, no more hereditary chairs for the imbecile sons of professors. Four, any student may attend class for a period of 15 days without paying fees to see if he likes the teacher.
And how if your program is not allowed? What then?
What then? That's easy. We establish our own institution, a free university. It's been done before. How do you think the University of Padua is founded? We, the students, are the university. We pack up and leave, then watch the townspeople come on their knees, begging us to return.
Ah, but I would remind you of the city ordinance decreeing the death penalty for any student who will conspire to transfer the university.
Ah, but I would remind you of the student privilege that supersedes all others. The right of cessatio, the right to strike, granted by the Pope himself. We can shut it down whenever we like.
What the devil are you saying?
Father, our struggle is historic. For generations, you merchants of the town have cheated us students.
We have?
Rents, outrageous rents for stinking basement rooms and leaking garrets.
Rents?
And food, a fortune for a lousy meal with sour wine and a lousy inn.
Ha!
We'll change that.
You can eat at home.
And the law that harasses us students. If one of us so much as looks at a townsman...
Looks at a townsman? Last week, your students... beat up a man that wouldn't let his daughter come out and join in your frolic.
Oh no, doctor, you've got it the wrong way around. It was the students who got the
beat. Oh, the students! Always the students!
Not always, father, but now, yes. It is a new day, a new generation!
No, you don't understand!
Wrong, father, you don't understand. The old never do.
The old don't understand, do you hear that?
There's a gap, father, a deep, wide gap.
Oh, a gap indeed, and you have found it. My congratulations. Adam and Eve had sons, and they had children, and there have been millions of generations since. But you are the first to discover that the old are not the young, and the young are not the old. My congratulations.
That's not the point.
I didn't have a father. I wasn't a son once. Nobody let me have a gap.
But father,
I wasn't allowed one. Well, let me tell you.
10 minutes.
No, let me tell you. You want us to do your work, but you make all the decisions. You tell us to become responsible, but you control all the money. You say to sit and think, but you send your assistants to lecture us. You say here is the world's knowledge, but the poor students can't even afford the price of a book. And you feed us an education that has no relevancy to the world outside.
Oh, no. We say be quiet and learn. But you brawl in the taverns. Riot in the streets!
And with cause, when we
fight
are...
and murder amongst yourselves! German students against French! North Italian against the South! Your student groups that you call guilds!
Fight! Of course we fight! We fight for the rights of the young! We fight!
And destroy! Last week you destroyed the quarters of the Night Watch! Do you have any idea how much money?
Money? I don't care about money.
Because you never had to make any!
What does money get you anyway? A materialistic society. A society that puts property values above human values.
I'm not human?
That's not the point.
The point is, you have no respect. No respect for your father, for your family, for the things that made you, for the things we gave you, for the sacrifices.
Oh yes, the sacrifices.
When I was your age, when I was your age, what time is it? Oh.
6 minutes.
Oh, Thalio, your old father is really going.
I'm sorry, Father, I didn't mean to.
Oh, don't be angry with me. Two things I asked for, and you can go back to the university.
Say Y-E-S.
Y-E. Yes, Father, if it will ease you, yes, I'll try.
Good. First, take over my affairs.
Yes, Father.
Next, become head of the family. Get yourself a son, a true Besignosi. Marry Isabella, my old friend Tofano di Scattarelli's daughter.
Isabella, that white-faced...
Oh, master, not so fast. You haven't looked. She's put on weight.
What? Oh, no, no, no!
Yes, 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 my son.
Very well, Father.
Oh, bless you. Quick, Arlecchino, go to Signor Tofano di Scattarelli and tell him to hasten here. Bring his doctor, bring his son. Contracts must be signed.
Yes, master. 3 minutes.
Oh, have you the strength, Father?
Strength? Yes, if you're with me.
Are you?
Yes, of course, Father.
Then bind the bargain. Swear that you will.
I will, Father, as Rector Magnificus, I solemnly swear.
Never mind the rector. Swear on yourself. Come, bare your breasts. On the mark of the Besignosi, swear that you will...
On the mark of the Besignosi, I swear.
Ah, touching, isn't it? And where does it lead? Just you wait and see.
Then...
You shall have him.
I shall.
You shall.
Oh. Oh, good.
But how? I don't know, but you shall.
Oh, thank you, Columbina.
Now read some more.
Oh, what stuff? This isn't love. Not really love. Oh, maybe it's all right for you. But in the kitchen, we do it differently. We don't talk. We, you know.
Oh, I don't know.
Well,
what do you do?
Well, for instance, we sit down and his knee touches my knee. Then his arm goes around my shoulder and his head just happens to fall.
Wait, I'll show you. Petulino, come here.
But the master needs me to get...
Always eating!
First, the arm. So... Second, third.
What? For dinner?
Oh, my body aches with chills.
I forgot the master.
What's the matter this time?
Oh, the usual. He was out in the town last night trying to act as if he was still 20 years old.
Oh dear, poor father. When will he grow up? Louder, master!
I'm dying, damn it.
Dying again? Oh dear.
Yes, death comes closer with each breath.
Don't breathe!
I have to breathe!
Breathe out every last of my hope. Last night I could not sleep for fear that I would not wake up.
Perhaps you won't die, Master.
I'm sure I will, thanks to old Pantalone.
Old Pantalone, what has he to do with this?
Well, we were sitting at the Gildenstud, and Pantalone, Dr. Graziano, and I sitting there drinking and recalling old times when we were young, and the terror of the town.
Yes, we know, and the hellion with the girls.
Yes, well, there happens to pass by a beautiful and desirable young lady. We were, well.
Stimulated?
Stimulated. We were stimulated. Our imaginations were stimulated. Pantalone, the old fool, got excited. And I got excited, and then there we were.
Excited!
Yes, and then Dr. Graziano came to the rescue and he told us a secret potion. A rejuvenator.
No!
Yes, and the long and the short of it was, he took us to his study where he mixed some concoctions together, and then he took us to the graveyard. There, in the dark of the moon, he told us to drink. Oh, I had real chills, you may be sure, but I drank. It tasted like the insides of a dead toad. But it did its work, for right there, in the middle of the night, still of the night in the middle of the graveyard, my loins tangled. And then we went back into town where we had one hell of a time.
Until at the break of dawn, Sylvia and I had to gather you up.
What's that?
Sylvia and I had to find you and bring you home. Master, you were drunk.
Me? Drunk? Nonsense.
Drunk, Master.
Okay. Why, you zany, call me drunk? I'll give you drunk!
Master!
Father!
Oh. Okay. He's good. He's good. Ah!
I got you a message. I came as quick as I could. I always hurry to the side of disease and death. Though, you should know I had to leave my class at the university, where my students eagerly awaited my...
Please, doctor. Doctor, I am sick.
Ah, what did you say, sick? Aha! Sickness is an ailment that affects men's health. It is brought on by illness. You are sick, therefore you are ill. Now you know.
Yes, Father.
Closer, my dear. Where I can see you. There, that's close enough.
Yes, Father.
I approach a sleep, my child, from which I will not wake. But before I sleep, I call upon your respect to fulfill your father's last request.
What is it you wish, Father?
I have arranged a marriage.
For me? To whom? Oh, it can't be! Oh.
I have a proposal from Signor Velotti, who wishes to have his son, Luigi, wedded to you.
Ooh.
Now, he's not a bright boy, but he does own that fine farm in Argenta. And there was one other offer from Antonio, the son of Signor Dotti, the rug merchant. Now, he's not much in appearance. His shoulders are a little rounded. Belly somewhat overfed, and one eye's a little crooked. But his father spoke well of him. I don't remember what it was. But his father spoke well of him. And then there was one other offer. Who could be from?
Was it Leo?
Yes, it was my friend Pantaloni di Pessignossi's son. It was
Leo! Why him, Father?
Well, he's bright and good looking, I'm told. But if it displeases
you. Oh, if it's your last request, Father!
Yes, I'm afraid it is.
Oh, Master Flavio!
Yes, where is my father?
Oh, it's Flavio. He isn't here.
Ah, Flavio. My son. Father? Ah, Flavio. How can I tell you? What is it, Father? I have sent for you, my only son, in the hopes that you would follow my footsteps, fill my shoes, take over the business.
Oh, but Father.
Please, Dr. Graziano is sending me on a long journey from which I will not return.
Father.
And as my parting wish, I ask for you to take over my affairs and become head of the family.
I'm sorry, Father. If it were as simple as filial obligation, I wouldn't hesitate. But I have found a new purpose. It is a quest for the inner state of being within me. I'm searching for the ultimate truth. Of identity.
Identity? But you're Flavio Di Scattarelli, my son.
No, Father, you don't understand. You're too old.
I understand. I don't understand.
Let me explain it this way. I see the world and the people in the world. And I loathe what I see. For the world is filled with wars, tyrannies, and religious and political cynicism. From these, I turn away, and I seek a new life. A life dedicated to one purpose. To love mankind.
Mankind? Those people.
Yes, Father. Those people. Love them in action. Love them in thought. And as we put it, in song. When I see a flower appear, when I feel a soft wind blow, then I know that love is near. That is all I need to know.
Yeah, exactly.
Love is how the world is made. Love is how. Love is how. When you love, you're not afraid. Love is now. Love is now.
Flavio.
Yes, Father.
And for what it represents, 100 years of respectability.
Respectability? Father! You see the faces of our debtors. There's no respect in their eyes, only distrust.
But they pay their debts, and in that there is respect.
Then let respect stay with you, for I will have none of it. This means I must leave Bologna.
No, no, here we are, and here we stay. Scattarelli you are, and Scattarelli you remain. You stay.
No, Father, for I am a Goliard.
A Goliard? Now you're Scattarelli. What's a Goliard?
A wandering student. One who carries from town to town the message of peace and love.
Yeah, yeah, we know one of those. Well, they're going from this country to that, strangely dressed, always begging and seldom sober.
Goliards! Escapist youth who have no goals or directions. They travel in all conditions, and they live together, boys and girls, in the same room.
That's disgusting.
Those are not the true wanderers. We are. We carry a message of love.
Love? Love won't do the harvesting. Love won't collect the rents.
Rents? What rents, Father?
The rents from the Piazza della Poggia.
Those are yours?
Yes, ours.
But the people there are poor. Many of them go without shoes.
We live in a warm climate.
They can't afford shoes because they have to save their money for the high rents.
But the rents buy you your clothes.
Then buy me no more fine clothes, for I will not let another man's poverty provide my prosperity.
Then what, my son, do you suppose pays for your education?
Ignorance, Father. The ignorance of the masters of slums who think they can buy my love with money.
Slum master. Master of the slums. You dare call me a slum master? Why, you ungracious hypocrite! Oh! Oh! I am stuck! Patient! Oh. Have patience with him. Flavio, my son. Time presses. Become a Goliard if you must. Sing your song. Spread your love. But as my last request.
Yes, Father?
First, settle my affairs. Take care of your little sister.
Well...
And if the rents become a little unreasonable, use reason. Sparingly. This I put to you as the last wish of a dying man.
Please, Flavio, he loves you.
Yes, young master.
Yes, master, do, do.
Very well, Father, I agree.
Good, now Pedrolino, hurry to the house of Di Bessignosi and bring Pantalone and his family here.
Yes, master, right away, master. Wait! The whole family?
Yes, contracts must be signed. So hurry, hurry!
Yes, master.
Ah, Flavio. And where does it lead? Well, just you wait and see.
One of your own town squares. Did you know that Dante and Petrarca once strolled through here? And from here you can see the Leaning Towers. Yes, we have Leaning Towers too. Two of them, there and there. The Piazza Piccioni, Pigeon Square. Thanks, St. Francis, they've gone home for now. I was just coming to your house.
You first. You. I was just coming to your house.
No, I was just coming to your house.
That's what I said.
That's what I said.
Well, that's where I heard it.
Your master and family are to come to our house. Oh, you first.
You.
Your master and family are to come to our house?
No, your master family are to come to our house, because my master is dying again.
So is mine.
What are we to do? Yes, and then?
Just see the sun.
Look over there. Tell me, what do you see?
Men and...
Stop right there. Now that one. Tell me about him.
Well, he's an old man.
What kind of old man?
Well,
Do you see the clothes he's wearing? The purse at his belt?
Yes.
Then what kind of old man?
Well,
Oh, a rich old man!
Good, you're learning. Now that one, tell me about him.
Well, he's a young man, but he doesn't look rich.
You're right, he isn't. Keep going.
Well, he's good looking. He looks exciting.
Yes, exciting. So tell me, why have we come to Bologna?
Don't tell me, I know. To see rich old men and exciting young men, right?
Right!
Educated in a convent, and what do you know? See? Nothing. But that's past. Now you must learn to use your commodities.
Commodities? Oh, we didn't pack any of those.
You are packed. Now you must learn to unpack. Here, I'll show you. First, I'll teach you how to bow.
Oh, I know that already. They taught us that at the convent.
Indeed, show me.
No, not like that. Like this.
Why so low?
Why so low? Because...
Oh! Here, let me.
Okay. Yes,
but you don't have to. They'll get it. Here, we'll try together. Suppose there were a group of men over there. And over there. That's it.
Oh, look! Someone is coming! It's an old man. Oh, Franceschina, may I try it on him?
Yes, and another old man at that.
Come quickly. Let's leave and watch.
They're here. We made it.
Mine are here, too. Jasmine. Come, Ezra. Come. This way.
Master, have a care. Slowly, step by step.
Careful, Master. Careful.
There. Now here is Signor Tofano.
Where?
And here is Signor Pantalone.
Oh, Pantalone. You see? Where?
There you are.
Yes, I see. That's you.
Signor Tofano. Señor Patan!
Oh, my God.
Senor Pantalon. Damn it!
Oh, God.
Wait, give me.
Oh, give me. How are you?
Not well. Not well at all.
Father, sit down.
Oh, it is the same with me. Oh, perhaps it is near the end.
Yes. Perhaps it's my time, too. I am possessed by the devil's set of cramps.
Oh, bad, too bad. My throat constricts, and I can dislodge nothing. Ugh.
What a pity. There is a tightening in my lower intestine that I cannot, dislodge.
Oh, my heart is a hammer. Oh, it's gonna break my ribs. Oh.
My breath is noxious. It sears my lungs.
Oh, truly, the end is near.
Yes, truly, the end is near. We must set our affairs in order.
We must arrange for the future.
When we won't be here.
Oh.
Doctor, do I have the energy?
Doctor, will I last?
Have you the energy? Will you last?
Stop such talk. It damages my reputation. You do not know your condition. That is for me to say. I will tell you when you are dying and when you are not. Right now, your effluviums are in a state of flux. Or as you might say, the false are in a balanced unbalance. But soon we shall see the false effluve into the true.
Oh, pray, Doctor, no more!
Peace, Doctor, peace!
Come, let us use our last energies for what remains.
Yes, let us close accounts.
Business!
Business!
My son Lelio takes over my business affairs. You may not know it, Topano, but I am a man of some means.
My son Flavio will become the head of our family. You may have not expected it, but we control some extensive holdings.
Oh, Topano, I've always favored the sights of addition. Two is such a splendid result when one is added to one.
Delone, I've always favored combinations. This, combined with that, always creates a splendid effect.
Excellent! May I assume that you propose a marriage between your daughter and my son?
Ah, you take my meaning exactly. Are we agreed?
We are.
Splendid.
Then let us speak of dowry.
Quite proper. But you realize, of course, that I'm not a rich man.
Oh, nonsense! Don't be modest. But for me, myself, these past few years have not been good. How much to endow your daughter?
But little, I'm afraid. How much against the chance of a widowhood?
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Then how much property?
Oh, property. Ugh.
Well, consider that you're getting a fine girl with many admirable qualities.
Oh, sure, you're right. But, on the other hand, my son Lelio is well educated. They think highly of him at the university.
Well, my daughter knows more than her share in learning.
My son is versed in languages.
My daughter knows several languages herself.
So, for a female, I suppose. But Lelio, demonstrate your excellence.
Legis silent inter arma. Cicero, translate. Laws are mute in the midst of arms.
Ta lecisa latitum tom cacon. Aristotle translated evils are. Poverty is the parent of revolution and crime.
Scalera non sunt mentienda eventae sed malus mentibus hominum. Cicero translated, crimes are not to be measured by the issue of events, but by the bad intentions of men.
Aide penius astine poiae de convergam. Aristotle, of evils we must choose the least.
Stultus Keelan Guam Chorus at Sethians Vidya Term, Oblivious. Translated, let a fool hold his tongue and he shall pass for a sage.
Non congi vit tempora silentis, qui no sermonis congi vit tempora. Also, Publius, he knows not when to be silent, he knows not when to speak.
Yoatin, yoagatin, to.
Marco Polo translated, once upon a time there was a man who stole a chicken.
Out of
here! Out, you baby!
Hands
on,
Finitas.
Finitas.
Colavina, I did it! Something happened!
What are you talking about?
Didn't you see that? He looked at me the way you said, like, in the kitchen.
Well, we are across him!
So let us come to cases.
Yes, let us.
For dower, how much?
500 florins and the rent for one Tuscan farm.
Father, for shame, 1,000 florins and the rent for two Tuscan farms.
Okay, fine.
Done.
And I guess the chance of her widowhood, how much?
Let's see, oh, the profit from the sailing brig, the snail, and the beautiful little diamond ring.
Father, for shame, the profit from the merchantman, the galloper, and the large diamond necklace.
Oh, all right.
Done. We settled and we can rest in peace.
Aye, all this done and we can fade away without regret. Oh, Dr. Graziano, attend us.
Oh, mistress, your grace.
Pause a moment. Here are people who can help us.
Oh, yes, I see. Here are people
of the town.
Rich old geezers and kind young fellows greet them.
Greet them?
Bow.
How you doing, babe?
Good sirs, well met. We are here.
Oh, of course, what can we do?
You see, we are strangers here, and...
And we've just come from the convent of the Little Sisters.
Where we spent several nights.
And we've come to Bologna because we've often heard that the men...
That the men and the women of the Duke's court are famed for their gentility.
Have you followers of the Duke?
Yes!
Well then, do you hear, mistress, we are among friends?
Yes, isn't that nice?
Well then, gentlemen, perhaps you can help us.
Oh, of course, anything for you.
You see, we have come to town expressly for the Duke's ball tomorrow night, my mistress being somewhat distantly related to him. And we require suitable lodgings. Would any of you be
Oh, lodgings? Why, nothing
lodgings,
easier.
Lodgings, actually, why I...
Oh, good gentlewoman, how opportune. May I offer you a room in my house? Comfortable. Well appointed.
Good gentlewoman, I have just the place for you. A room ready and waiting with supper laid on.
Supper, of course, and musicians playing for your pleasure.
Oh, sirs, how kind. Well, of course.
Well, of course, my mistress appreciates your offer, but she does have her position to think of. A good inn would be most suitable.
Until she can inform the Duke of her arrival.
Gentlemen.
What, again?
Yes, business is business.
Arlecchino, do you hear that?
Yes, master.
I must meet that lady.
Oh, wonderful elixir.
I too will go to the ball. I must meet that lady.
Miraculous elixir! Do you have an invitation?
No, but one can be purchased.
Where?
At the Duke's.
When?
Tomorrow. Arrange it. Put me something in it for you.
What?
I'll think it.
I already have 3 soldini.
1.
2.
Angelina, you rascal!
Yes, master.
I will go to the ball.
Will? That doctor is a magician.
I must meet that lady.
A magic magician. We have no invitation.
That can be managed. I tell you, I must meet that lady secretly.
Where?
At the Duke's.
When?
Tomorrow night at the ball. See to it. You'll be rewarded.
How?
Think of something.
3 soldini.
1. 2.
My master is dying. Save his life.
How?
Arrange a meeting with your mistress.
When?
Tomorrow night.
Where?
Duke's Garden. 1 florin.
5!
2!
4!
3!
Print an old man's dying wish.
How?
Arrange a meeting with your mistress.
Tomorrow night?
Yes.
Deuce Garden?
Yes.
Five.
One.
Four.
Two.
Three.
Yeah. Arlecchino, the lady.
You?
Me.
When?
Tomorrow night.
Duke's Garden?
Duke's Garden.
Tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night.
Duke's Garden?
Duke's Garden.
My young master.
Garden?
Night.
My young master.
Garden?
Night.
You see, mistress, just two strolls through this square and already the riches of Bologna are pouring in.
There, Colombina, did you see that?
Indeed.
Lelia was after something.
Indeed.
What? Isabella, some kind of assignations are being made.
Well, that vixen shall not have my Lelio.
Colombina, help me!
I will, mistress, or my name is not
Colombina. Oh, the Signorina is here. We must find out what she will wear at the ball.
I'll ask.
No, not directly. I'll ask.
Oh, lady, so nice to see you this evening. Your mistress is so lovely. Will you be at the ball?
Yes.
I could just see you in a yellow dress.
Oh, no, never yellow. My color is pink.
I would have known it with lace.
No, brocade.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Isabella Florinda Aurelia di Scatero.
And I am Vittoria Violetta. Vittoria.
Friday,
Volare. Oh, cantare. Oh, let's fly way up to the clouds, away from the maddening crowds. We can sing in the glow of a star that I know will always enjoy peace of mind. Let us leave the confusion and all this illusion behind. Just like birds of a feather, a rainbow we definitely find. Oh, Lare. Oh, hey, Cantare. Oh, my happy heart sings. Your love is giving me wings.
Activities, but oh well, can smell out a profitable deal. Then they're the young ones. At a ball like this, you don't have to waste time being polite to the old hags on the ballroom floor. Go straight to the hidden spots in the garden. And my assignation has already been made. Oh, how is this?
Ah, what an occasion! Who but me knows what I am after? Inside, I can mingle with those who hold the power, stand beside them in my power's presence, and begin to reach for it. Outside, well, there's the girl from the convent, so innocent, so desirable, and oh, so ready.
Ah, what an opportunity.
First, I go inside to listen to pride, picking up bits and pieces of scandal to spice my songs. I have to. How else is a goliard supposed to carry his message of peace and love? Love? Well, that too. It's already been set up, remember?
Listen! Music! Laugh! Oh, what is playing for them is work for me, man of science that I am, the love pestilence! That is my stuff. What's the new name? The one taken from that shepherd fellow? Sifa! Sifa!
Sifa!
Sifa! Oh, something or other. Now, something tells me there's much to be learned about the subject on a night like this.
Columbina, tonight my lady seeks the arms of another.
But tonight we shall find yours or my cunning will fail me.
But how?
The Signorina is here. Let us see how she is dressed.
Oh, yes.
Oh, lady, lady, so nice to see you this evening. My mistress and I were just going into the ball. Will you join us?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Not now, don't waste it.
Oh, what a lovely gown. May we see it?
Yes, how charming you look, may we?
Oh, yes. How pretty.
How charming.
I thought so. Francesca can help me make it at the convent.
Yes, I thought it needed a little adjustment here and there. That's okay.
See how alike they are?
To be sure. We're going in. Will you be joining us?
Oh, at last we're here. Come quickly, let's go.
Up your way, mistress. So, they're here.
All of them?
Yes, both the old men and their sons. So, now we must get ready to business.
Oh, but there's so much going on inside the palace. Can't it wait?
No, we're not here for pleasure, we're here for business.
Oh, but can't we just...
No, how are we to eat? How are we to wear clothes? You're wearing the only other dress you have now.
But...
No, it's work for us, my girl. So now we decide to move on.
Which one?
The richest. Now you sit here. Go sit like a lady.
But what will I say?
That I leave to you. Find out how many farms, how many houses, how many jewels each one has.
What if they don't want to tell me?
They will. Just use your commodities. Now, you wait here and I'll send the first one in. Oh, look, he's already coming.
Which one?
Signor Tofano di Scattarelli. Don't forget, this is the night of our big chance. Good luck, mistress.
Oh, dear. Is someone there?
Yes, indeed. Guess who?
The Duke?
No, but...
Signor Pantalone?
Pantalone? Here, what a joke. He's so old, he can't walk now. Who?
Signor Tofano di Scattarelli.
How did you know?
I don't know. Your hands, I guess. They just felt so old, so cold.
Oh, but they're not. I'm not. You should see me inside.
Inside? I should?
I'm warm. I'm on fire!
That's nice. How many farms do you have?
What? Farms? What farms? I live here in town.
What do you have here in town? Houses, jewels?
Oh, but you, my dear, not what I've got, it's what you've got. Oh, some soft hands. What's this? An elbow. Ooh, what a lovely curve.
Haven't you ever seen an elbow before?
Oh, but not like this one. It's adorable, incomparable. It turns into a... What can this be?
What can it be? Why, it's my shoulder, you silly man.
The shoulder?
You don't say.
Look how easily it blends into a... Is this neck?
Yes, but you don't have to scratch your hand.
Dear lady, what are necks for?
A neck is to wear pretty things, like pearls.
You're the pearl.
And diamonds.
You're the diamond. The sight of you makes me want to stroke you, to hold you close. Come, feel my heart. Come, feel my arms. Let me.
Ah!
Oh my God.
What happened? He tried to grab me.
As Is that all? How rich is he?
I don't know.
Diamonds, anything?
I don't think he likes diamonds.
Well, what did you find out?
He likes my neck.
Oh, merciful heaven, now this time!
What if he tries to grab me again?
Let him, but find out. Do you hear? Find out!
I can't!
Fine, switch. Give me your cloak.
Nope, don't tie it.
There you go. Look who's on. Help me.
But now,
you go to the end of the garden.
Of course, if you say.
Oh, senor! Did we take a little fall? Oh. There now. Up we go.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
What have you been eating, senor? There, now where were we? You were saying something about my face, perhaps.
Ah, just so. What a lovely face in your cheeks. So rosy.
Yes, it's from the country air on the farm. Do you have one?
Yes, I have a farm. But your cheeks.
Just one?
No, both of them.
Yes, good servant, how many farms have you?
Oh, you see, I have a... three, I think. But your cheeks.
Oh, my cheeks, not mine. Yours, senor. So firm. 3 farms, did you say?
Yes, 3, I think.
And in town you have a house, or?
Yes, I have a tomb.
Tomb?
And some other property.
My, what a man of business you are!
Are you in business?
Business? Of course! Sausages.
Sausages?
I'm famous for any fine a bologna sausage, you find a bit of me.
Guy, what a man you are!
Let's recap. We have 3 farms, 2 houses, sausages. Not bad. Could be worse.
Oh, senor! Did you fall? I didn't know!
There! Up we go!
Are you all right? Oh! Well, how'd you do that?
Is this what you intended? To take me in your arms? Your strong arms?
Yes, of course.
Indeed!
And then what?
Well, I don't know. It's been so long. I...
Do you intend to carry me away in your strong arms?
Carry? That's exactly what I'll do. Carry you up.
Oh, you and Trancer.
Lie with me.
I will, my dear, I will.
Oh, joy. Oh, rapture. Oh, rapture, bliss.
Oh, but we must be careful.
Careful?
Oh, the Duke.
Oh, yes, the Duke.
Think of him. Would he permit?
What shall
we do? Oh, I got it.
Go home. Find a pilgrim's cloak with a hood for your head. Then meet me here. I'll be dressed the same as you.
And thus disguised, we will fly!
Oh. Yes, we will.
And then, you know.
Oh, yes, I do.
Then why do you tarry away, away?
Yes, I'll be home. Soon.
Soon.
Christina!
Yes?
Look who I found. One of the young ones. He says he's a poet, and he likes all sorts of nice things. Flowers, and people.
Not likes, loves. Loves flowers, people, and all the things that God made.
Doesn't he talk nice? You say such pretty things.
They come easier when I'm talking to you. Beautiful people.
You mean me, maybe?
Yes, you are one of God's beautiful creatures. Ah, how perfect this is. You charm the night. You charm the place. You charm me.
Oh, how poetic you are. How prettily you say things.
Poetry, yes. Poetry is my life. I write about it.
knife. Would you like to hear one of my poems?
Oh, yes.
It's called Entering. In, out, to, fro, hello, goodbye, goodbye, a wave, a tear, a clear and liquid sorrow shining on your face. Your dear and entering face. To, fro, come, go, hello, hello, hello. Do you like it?
Oh, yes. I don't understand it, but I like it.
Do you feel love?
I love love.
Come, go with me, and we'll wander from town to town, country to country. A whole new world.
Wander? Oh no, I've wandered enough already. I want to settle down.
Settle? That's no life for a Goliard.
Goliard? What's that?
A wandering student. One who sees and sings of the beauty of life. Carry a message of love. Here, there, everywhere.
But isn't life beautiful just right here?
Of course it is.
And when you say your poetry and talk of all the pretty, lovely things, why, all those other places would have to be just as nice as it is now, where we are. Don't you think?
Yes, I do. But when you smile, I don't think. What does it matter? Here, now?
And Bologna is such a nice place. With you.
And with you. I promised my father I'd stay for a while, take over his affairs.
Then wouldn't you, couldn't you?
I could if you would.
When we.
Oh!
No. That's enough, that's far enough.
Oh dear, I forgot, I didn't ask the question.
Doesn't matter, you already got the answers. Now look, you two, this will never work.
Why not?
Because someone is coming! The Duke, maybe! Yes! Or someone! No, you must not be seen together. I'm sir, if you have any feelings for my mistress, go!
But I don't
go!
Want...
Go! Quickly!
But do you, my Bologna, go, we are. We'll roam right here, won't we?
Yes, we will. You and I will wander
from here to there. Go!
Adieu.
All right, gather yourself, flower girl.
Oh, he's wonderful, so sweet.
Yes, but we know about him. He's hooked onto the next.
Which one?
Old Pantalone di Pesariosi.
Another old one? I don't like them.
You must think about our future.
But I get all mixed up, and they grab you just everywhere.
Yoo-hoo! Lady dear!
Oh, dear.
Oh, little flower, little blossom.
I can't.
Then leave it to me. Go.
Someone's being very quiet.
But nobody is here.
Yeah, someone is creeping up on me.
Surprise!
Surprise yourself!
Ah, what a fortunate young fellow I am to find here.
Yes, sir, how fortunate.
Fortunate enough to make me want to take your hand.
Oh, senor.
Oh, such an arm, such a sweet arm. Oh. And this elbow, just see how it curves leading up.
Oh,
can this living piece of pure alabaster-rich shoulder? How smooth, how round, and where does it lead?
Well, let's skip the neck. Are you a farmer?
Oh, no, I'm a shipping merchant.
A sailor, I might have known. But you live here in Bologna?
Yes, alas, for many years. You see, we traced my wife and little daughter here until we lost them. But Let's not talk about me. Let's talk about you.
Talk about me, little old me.
No, not talk, signorina. Sing a sweet serenade. The song I entitled, You. You are my lucky star. I saw you from afar. Your wandering eyes at me, they were gleaming, beaming. I was starstruck. You are my lucky.
What the devil are you doing here?
Hey, dear father.
Your place is inside. Oh, I missed the man.
Me inside? Oh, no, father. Tonight, inside is for the old.
Old?
Outside is for us, the young. Rooms for the old, gardens for the young.
Oh, ridiculous. You don't know your father. The hours I have spent.
Just so, father. Hours in the night air. I've witnessed your rheumatism, your recent indigestion. And you're singing to the night air to nobody. Father, you haven't been seeing things, have you?
Oh, of course not, you young scamp. I was singing to, well, never mind. At your age, you wouldn't understand.
Age, father? You're talking about age? Whatever it is I couldn't understand at my age, you certainly couldn't do it at yours.
You scoundrel, you disrespectful young—
Oh, come, father, don't splutter. Sing it.
Away, away, out of my sight, you wretched, ungrateful creature of loveliness. Oh, who? What? Where?
Yes, senor, you were saying before we were interrupted.
Interrupted? No, he just came in. He just,
Oh, sir, never mind him. Speak only to me, that is, if you care.
Care? Of course I care.
Then prove it.
Prove it, but how? You mean now?
Yes, now. Go, sir.
Go. Go? Now?
Yes, now. So that no one, not even your son, knows when we intend to fly.
Oh, to fly.
Oh, yes, fly. Oh, to fly.
Hurry away, but just for a little while. Meet me back here, wearing a disguise. Oh, I know. Get a pilgrim's cloak with a hood to hide your head.
Yes, yes.
Meet me back here, and thus disguised, we will fly.
That's it.
Then fly. Hurry away, my sweet one.
Princess Dana.
Yes.
Is it clear?
That's it clear.
I was just here. I heard everything.
And saw, I hope.
He was just like the other one. He tried to paw you.
Yes, but that is to be expected. They're all like that.
Paw? But the young ones aren't.
Give them some time and they will be. But yeah, we have to focus on the old ones.
You mean I have to spend the rest of my life with an old man?
No, mistress, not the rest of your life. Just the rest of his.
Yoo-hoo!
Yoo-hoo!
My little pink blossom.
Yoo-hoo! My sweet one. Come here, dear one. No! You come here, carissima!
What? Oh, look! It's
yes,
a pilgrim!
Yes, look! And oh, what a pilgrim. Come, mistress, off this way.
Ooh. 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 Ooh.
What's that? It sounds like my master.
No, it sounded like my master.
It is our masters!
What are we to do?
Send for a doctor.
Who?
Dr. Graziano!
Dr. Graziano!
Dr. Graziano!
Who? What? Did someone call?
Quick, doctor, hurry!
I'm here. What seems to be your problem? Look!
See here?
Hey. Hey. I must tell you this about these two.
Yes?
They are unconscious.
No.
This means they have lost their wits. Ergo, they are helpless. Helpless, they are unable to stand. It follows that they seek a supine position. Now they are supine, ergo, they are unconscious.
But what are we to do?
This obviously calls for action. They must be conveyed.
Yeah.
Carried to a better place.
Where? What?
Comfort is needed. Where does comfort reside? In the home. Ergo, we must carry them home.
Who's home? Ergo's?
Who is Ergo?
Call for help.
Ergo!
Ergo!
This will never do. Come, you there, Aniyama, Aniyama, help us lift them.
Hypocrites? The old keep telling us that we're not experienced, but we're honest. You can trust us.
Oh? To do what?
To get to the point.
What about the farms, the jewels, about what you can offer?
I can offer my life, my love, my body.
Your body? No.
Oh, yes.
No.
Oh, yes, I'm going to catch you and hold you and...
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, I am. You will not escape me. I will take your little hand. I will pull you close. I will look into your eyes and stroke your hair and lift your head. And then... Our lips will meet.
Our lips?
Yes, ours.
Oh. You mean like this? You said honest, is that what you meant?
What? Yes, indeed.
So then you show me.
There, see?
I think I see.
Then I'll show you again.
No, maybe a little hypocrisy is a good thing.
Never, listen, I loved your kiss, the feel of your arms, and when I look at you here tonight, I want to say, I love you. I want you to be mine.
You do?
Yes.
Really? Then say it again.
Be mine, be mine.
Oh, Lelio, I will.
Oh, you lovely girl, oh, you sweet lady. I could dance, I could shout, I could circle the globe.
Oh, there you are. Where did you go?
Go? I've gone to the moon, I've gone to the stars.
You have? There?
Yes, and you with me. This is the way it shall always be.
You and me.
Nothing else matters.
Not the farms, not the jewels.
I'll give you jewels. I'll hang them on your neck, where they will sparkle on your bosom.
Oh, that'll be nice.
Yes, your lovely neck, white neck, with its delicate, soft skin.
Oh, should you?
Yes, of course, they would hang just there.
I don't think you should.
Why not? Your neck is so lovely, and oh, and your shoulder, such a beautiful shoulder, so white, so lovely. What? What?
Yeah.
Sister!
What? What?
The dear sister, long-lost sister!
Brother! I saw that coming from the start!
But mother, where is she?
Alas, I do not know. I only know that I was left at the convent with the good sisters raised me. There I stayed until it was time to leave, and as Francescina says, seek my fortune. Do you have one?
What?
Fortune.
Yes, of course, our father is rich. But come, we must hurry home and reveal all that has happened. Ah, what regret. I have lost a love, but oh, what joy. I have found a sister.
And I a brother. Oh, I like that. Dear, dear brother.
Let us go. Come, sister.
Yes, brother.
It's me again, back to tell you where we are. It's Pantalone de Pesagliozzi's home. Why, his instead of Senor Tofano's. Well, it's closer to the Duke's garden. And besides, Pantalone's back wall rolls easier. It doesn't stick as often. Senor Pantalone de Pesagliozzi's home. Shh, I hear someone coming.
Shh. Quiet. Hush. I must focus my mind, concentrate my powers, so that I may draw from the stars the wisdom they contain. Oh, astrology! Oh, medicine! Oh, sisters twain! Be of help! Serve me in this frightful time! Astrology and medicine are sister sciences, you know? Like all sisters, in any happy family, they aid. They comfort each other in times of trial. Now, when I gaze upon these cross-stitchers, my senses tell me this is truly such a time, which is why I make my appeal to the sisters. Oh, astrology! Oh, medicine!
Oh, Dr. Graziano, have pity for heaven's sake!
Pity? Ah, pity's a virtue all men seek.
Please attend him, our father.
Doctor, Signor Di Pesagliozzi groans for help.
I hear he does. And help is here ahead. Eustheron, fetch my alchemy chart. Bring forth my book for formulae. Briskly. Now, which one of these fortunate, unfortunates, shall have the benefit of my attention first? This or that?
Please attend him, my father first.
My father first, Al.
My master has a dire need, doctor.
Let me see. Pantalone was negligent in the payment of fees for the dosage I gave him. Ergo, to follow first.
Oh, thank you, doctor.
Now, Mark, are you all attentive? You, come hold the chart so. Ah, node 10, and node 10. Now I have it. Sagittarius the Centaur is in his ascendancy, passing Leo the Lion, who is in his descendancy. Come, bring my book. Lodestone's weight starts to gravitate. Sagittaire begins to impair this man as a man, and alluvium begins to improve him with the purity of mercury. My instruments, my knife, my syringe.
These are my friends. See how they glisten.
Pantalone.
Oh, Tofano.
Where are we?
Yes.
What are we doing here?
Where are we?
Father, be quiet!
Father, be still!
Be easy, Master.
Now, Master, don't
take on so.
Dr. Graziano was only going to cut you.
Cut me?
What are those things for?
These things? Why, to cure you?
Cure? Those? You know, Pantalon, I feel better already.
Oh, I feel pretty good myself.
What? You feel good? You feel better? Nonsense! You feel bad. You feel terrible. Sad!
All that's required is one short cut.
A cut? Nah, who's cut?
Dr. Graziano, I feel very good. You have no idea how good I am.
Oh, me, I feel pretty good too.
Yes, yes.
Oh, Tufano, you've recovered.
Indeed, I feel fine. Hale and hearty.
That's it. Hale and hearty. You'll see. The old vigor has returned.
Father, I'm so glad.
Oh, it's good to be alive.
Yes, alive. We're alive!
Alive and full of gratitude, I trust? For one whose skills cured your ailments. For I am Dr. Graziano!
Father, Father, are you there?
Where are we? Who's home? Go in,
Mr. What's wrong, Master?
Father!
Father!
What?
Father? She belongs to us.
To us?
We found out.
You see, it was like this. Father, how can I say it?
Yes, Father, how can we say it?
What, for God's sake, what?
We discovered.
We uncovered.
We revealed.
The mark!
The mark!
Father!
Daughter!
Mistress!
Oh, get out of here. Is it? I can't even be. How did this come about?
Well, you see, Father, I was.
Yes, Father, he was.
Well, in the bushes.
It was natural.
Never mind. Oh, what a wonderful occasion. I've recovered my health and my daughter.
Oh, wonderful for me. I have a father and a brother.
And I a sister. But alas, I have lost a love.
Not entirely. I shall love you, just like a sister should.
It's not quite the same thing.
Besides, there were others. Wasn't there another girl in the garden tonight? I know there was another boy. He's sweet, and he talks so beautifully of the stars and poetry and love.
Who doesn't? It's the Bologna trademark.
Now, Master.
What?
Where were you tonight?
In a garden.
Oh, did you, were you?
In, out, to, fro, hello, goodbye. Hello.
It's you! Father, brother, the poet, and he isn't going to wander. He's going to stay right here and sing and love everybody.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
And I want him.
What?
And I want her, Father. Can I have her?
Right.
Oh, we'll stay right here and settle down. I'm so happy.
Congratulations, sister. Congratulations, Flavio, brother. My loss, your gain.
But you didn't lose. Signorina Vittoria was right. There was another girl in the garden tonight.
There was? Where?
Show him, mistress.
I dare not. Not here.
Yes, here. Where better? Get ready, new master. Now, mistress, now.
Wait a minute. You were the one. Then I didn't lose after all. Father, this is the one, the only one. Isabella, could you?
Yes, of course you will. Take her, you nasty, nice, mud-throwing young man.
I will. I mean, Father, may I?
What's that? Take her? You've already got her. We arranged that for you yesterday.
Of course, so you did.
Well, Pantalone, old rascal, they're taken care of. What next?
Not old Pantalone, you rogue. Young. Young Pantalone never felt better.
Well, Father, since everything has turned out so well, then all can be as it was.
What's that?
Exactly. Now that you've recovered and are your old young selves again, you can take over the family affairs.
Naturally.
And we can return to our proper pursuits.
Exactly. My title is not forfeit. I am still Rector Magnificus.
Back to the university.
Back to my student guild. Here's to
you. Sounds like great.
How is it with you, Master? Not
ill again?
Oh, I'm not ill.
Master, what's the matter? Are you all right?
Oh, no, I'm right enough, I suppose.
Well, old Pantalone, look where we are.
Yes, old Tofano. Right back where we started from.
All that fine feeling gone to waste.
All that energy lost.
Lost?
Oh.
Come now, Master. Look at your children.
Yes, be like them.
Did you ever see such joy?
Such rapture.
There, you see, again, we are left behind.
Yes, old, lonely, withering away.
Oh, why can't we be like them? We have desires, we have lust.
Yes, but alas, old friend, there's too great a gap between our desires and their commodities.
That's it.
What?
That damn gap. Well, we never had one of those gaps before.
No, we weren't allowed one.
Now, Father, let's not start that.
And why not? We had much right as they. We were young ones.
We didn't know there was one.
We were too busy working so that they could have theirs.
So we lost out.
Lost? Hell, we were cheated.
We were. And not even like that.
Neither do I. But alas, too late, I suppose.
Yes. I suppose.
Is it? No, my God, it isn't. They've had theirs.
And they're settled. Now we can have ours.
We will, by the heavens.
By the gods, we will. You've got your girl. I give you my business. Now, damn it, give me your position.
But Father.
No buts. We'll have to play turnabout.
So we will. You, if there's going to be a gap in this family, I'm going to have it. Give me your guitar.
But, Father...
To hell with your butts! Give me your guitar.
Let's have your list of non-negotiable demands.
But, Father...
Let's have them.
Demands.
Guitar. Maelio, what do you think? Should we let them?
I suppose, but we better warn them.
How?
Well, tell them.
No, that won't work. It's been my experience. You can't tell them anything. Not at that age. You just have to let them figure it out for themselves.
Well, too bad, but they'll learn. Shall we let them do it? Take over?
Yes, should we? It's a sacrifice.
Right. It's giving up all we've planned.
All we've worked for.
Does it?
Does it? No, by the gods!
No, by the heavens, it doesn't! If we can get our hands on the power structure, and at our age...
Well, there's still time!
The voice of the young won't just be the voice of tomorrow, it'll be the voice of now!
A message of peace and love won't have to wait. Give us our chance now and in a few years.
It'll be a new day. Now.
All right, Father, we agree. Shall we?
We shall.
After you.
No, after you. Future rector.
All right, flower boy. Non-negotiable demands. 1, any professor tardy to his 6 a.m. lecture class will be fined 10 florins. Do you hear that, Professor Musilli? Have yours ready. 2, professors who dodge difficult questions, 15 florins. 3, no more hereditary chair for imbecile sons of professors. 4, any student may attend any class they like for 15 days without payment to see if he likes a teacher.
When I see a flower appear, when I feel a soft wind blow, then I know that love is here. That is all I need to know.
It worked! It worked! Now who am I?
by my miracle elixir.
You, sir? I'm sure it could help you. Well, what about you, sir? Or you, ma'am? I'm sure it could help your husband.
To all here present, let it be known that the duly established laws, regulations, and provisions enacted by the duly appointed and elected Council of Citizens of this our notable republic, being proven by above 120 years' experience to be of great use and advantage to the inhabitants, do forthwith declare this law for those who pass within the confines of our city.